Calorimetry. Dear students, let's start this discussion with the concept of isolated system. When a hot aluminium ball is inserted in water, what will happen? The temperature of water increases. Or in other words, heat is transferred from aluminium ball to water. But during this action, some of the heat may escape in the surrounding. Can we make a system in which heat is not allowed to escape in the surrounding? Such system is called isolated system. In isolated system, heat is neither allowed to come inside the system, nor it is allowed to escape in the surrounding. And hence, total heat in the isolated system remains constant. Now, we will explore this concept to explain calorimetry. In general, calorimetry means measurement of heat. A device used for this purpose is called calorimeter. A typical calorimeter is shown in the figure. It is generally made of copper vessel containing water and a stirrer of same material. Whole assembly is kept in a wooden jacket containing heat insulating material such as glass wool, etc. The speciality of this box is that the outer layer acts as heat shield that does not allow heat to come inside the box. Hence, it provides thermal isolation from surrounding. A thermometer is inserted into the vessel through a small opening. It helps to measure the temperature inside the vessel. A sample to be burnt is kept in a closed chamber called bomb. This chamber is supplied with compressed oxygen to facilitate burning process. When current is passed through ignition wires, the sample catches fire and burn. Heat released by the sample gets absorbed by the water and the copper vessel. Stirrer is used for uniform mixing of heat. As a result, there is temperature rise in the thermometer. With the formula of specific heat capacity, it is possible to find the heat transferred in the system. Thus, principle of calorimetry states that total heat released by hot object is equal to total heat received by cold object. That is, heat loss is equal to heat gain.